couple of Wisconsin judges lost their seats last week for reasons that had nothing to do with how they performed on the bench. In Ozaukee County, Judge Tom Wolfgram lost to attorney Joe Voylin, whose sole issue was Wolfgram signing the petition to recall Governor Walker. In Dane County, Judge Rebecca St. John lost to attorney Rhonda Lanford. St. John was appointed by Governor Walker, and Lanford made that an issue in her campaign. Judicial races in Wisconsin are supposed to be nonpartisan, but are those days long gone? We're asking former Supreme Court Justice Janine Geske, now a professor at Marquette University Law School. Professor Geske, it's great to have you back on the program.
Good to be here, Mike.
Well, let's talk about it. Is this a quaint relic of the past, this notion that our judicial races are impartial and non-ideological?
Well, it appears that we certainly have gone that direction in the last several years, that the parties are lining behind one candidate or another, and I think they're actively recruiting candidates to run. And I think that's very unfortunate, because the whole idea of a nonpartisan judiciary has been part of our tradition in Wisconsin since the drafting of our Constitution, unlike other states where, in fact, they have partisan judges.
Does it discourage a potential candidates for judge from running?
I think it discourages candidates, and it changes who it is that is going to be deciding our cases in the state. Because historically, when candidates ran for the position, the idea was to get as many people from either side, Republicans, Democrats, criminal defense lawyers, prosecutors, to show that you had support generally from people who use the system. And now if you get partisans, there's this sense by the electorate that those judges are going to rule consistent with that partisan interest. And I think that's very dangerous.
I would imagine that if you're thinking about running for judge these days, that you have to think extra hard about who you associate with, who you avoid, what you say publicly. I mean, Tom Wolfgram's case in Ozaukee County is interesting because you had some law enforcement people there said, we think he did a pretty good job, but he signed the Walker recall petition.
Well, I think that's absolutely right. I think, you know, historically, when somebody was interested in a judicial appointment or running for a judge, they would try to be involved in the community on all issues, in all, you know, and really be involved both with Republicans and Democrats and very, very different viewpoints. And you worried about being involved and being somebody who cared about the community. Now, I think the issue is, are you lining up politically with one of the parties? Are they going to be there for you to support you? And I think some of our races bore that out this time. And I think that's extremely unfortunate, because the whole idea of that branch of government is that they're independent and they're not bound to either party.
You make the point, though, that there are some places where these elections are partisan affairs. Are we maybe just not admitting the reality that exists here, and maybe we should change to fit this new reality?
Well, I personally think that's a really bad idea, because you do lose that independence then. Then you have judges representing interests or aligned politically and philosophically with one party. And the whole idea is it's a check and balance on the governor's office and on the legislature, regardless of who's in power. And I think it really changes the nature of the kind of justice you get in the state.
Rebecca St. John, who was the Dane County judge who lost on Tuesday night, an appointee of Governor Walker, and that was certainly a key issue in that race. The governor has said, based on his what's happened in Dane County, it's happened to him a couple of times now, his appointees lose. He first said he didn't think he was going to appoint anybody to fill those jobs. Now he said maybe reserve judges or whatever. What's your reaction to that?
Well, constitutionally, he's required to appoint somebody if there is a vacancy. I understand his frustration, and frankly, I share frustration that people are ousted out of office simply by the determination of who appointed them. But on the other hand, he has an obligation to appoint, and those candidates are going to have to work really hard to be able to get more people supporting them on both sides. And I know that she did, but not enough, obviously, and it didn't carry the day.
I think I'll wrap this up with a personal question. You were a circuit court judge. You were a Supreme Court justice. Knowing what you know about how races are run today, what campaigns look like, what candidates are expected to do and not to do, would you run for office? Would you run to be a judge today?
I don't think I would. I don't think I would. I really ran as a community-based lawyer who was involved with a lot of people. I didn't have much money. I didn't have many political ties. I worked very hard, and I, you know, and that's how I ran both the circuit court and the Supreme Court. And this partisan races with all this big money in, and the requirement that so much money be spent on the races, I think I would have chosen a different path.
Former Supreme Court Justice Janine Geske, now a professor at Marquette University Law School. Great to have you on the program.
Thanks, Mike.
Next, why Wisconsin County is tackling climate change and what it can really do about it. But first, in the WIS Politics week ahead, an assembly committee could vote Thursday on a bill to cut Milwaukee County supervisors to part-time jobs.